talk to you about how to make a proper Southern meal. That's the cook sheet. So I'm not going to tell you everything you need to know, every half teaspoon of this and the other. It's all on that sheet, and it can be found on my website as well. So I'm just going to kind of encourage you to try something maybe you haven't tried before. Don't tell anybody, but this is all vegetarian. It can be made vegan if that's your thing. So for all of us that trust the adage that says never trust a skinny cook, I thought I should establish my cornbread cred. I was raised in a small town in Arkansas, and for those of you who have not ever lived in a small town, congratulations. But here's what the pie looks like. There's 3 out of 30 are catfish restaurants where I was raised. Barbecues, 5 out of 30. Pizza, 4, and steak, 10. No Thai, no Italian, no sushi, no Indian. But my granny taught me everything I needed to know about cooking Southern food. She's my number one cred. Everybody on count of three say aw. 1, 2, 3.
Aw.
So let's get on with it. Why should you make this? It's cheap if you need to buy absolutely every ingredient that's on the list. It costs you about $12. You can feed yourself and 3 friends for $12. And if you go back to make it again, you can buy all the stuff for about $4. The tools are very simple. Measuring spoons, measuring cup. I recommend an iron skillet. You can also use a pie plate and a whisk. The number one secret to making great cornbread is to heat the oil. This is the thing that's not in the in any of the cookbooks. You just want to turn on the oven and go ahead and put the 1/4 cup of oil that the recipe says in the pan. Don't set off your smoke detector. It only needs to sit there for about 7 minutes. So the ingredients, there's like 7 ingredients. They're very straightforward. You can find it in the supermarket all day long. So the other thing is buttermilk. It's weird your grandpa drinks it, but go to the store and get it. It is the secret, not the Yankee cornbread, not the the stuff with sugar in it. So you just want to put it all in a bowl, mix it up, pour it in the pan, put the oil with it, bake it for like 18 minutes. So the next thing on the menu is collard greens, mustard greens, poke salad. If you've never cooked greens, I suggest that you absolutely do it. Poke salad is my personal favorite. It's this weird stuff that grows in the alley. I'm sure you know all about poke salad. You want to get this stuff with the pink stems and harvest it in the spring because it becomes like poisonous in the fall. The Declaration of Independence was written with the ink made from poke salad berry juice. You know, a little bit of trivia. And then the last thing on the menu is chicken fried tofu with gravy, because in the South, gravy is its own food group. So what you want to do for the tofu is super simple. You just slice it up into 1/4-inch slices. You dredge it in this really mysterious stuff called nutritional yeast. And you can get it in like Whole Foods and New Seasons. It's this very strange stuff that I had never used before. It's definitely worth getting. You just dredge it in the nutritional yeast, put it in the frying pan, and fry it up, and then you make gravy. That's the whole reason for making chicken fried tofu. Gravy is very simple. It's oil, flour, fat, and milk. You just stir it all together. I've got all the specific directions in there, and the recipe is also available on my website, skinnywhitegirl.com/cornbread. I run out of copies. And so in the last 30 seconds, I just want to say for any of you widen people out there, I'm a graphic designer. And the birdie says do it. And my personal project that's coming up is called I Hate Hummer. And for anybody who thinks that hummers are a symbol of everything that's wrong with America, please come to I Hate Hummer. Give me your website. And we're going to be doing citizen citations and flyers that you can quickly leave on gas guzzlers. So for anybody